program are those of the participants and do not reflect the views of BronxNet or the program underwriters.
BronxNet. Your voice, your views, your vision.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Open. This is the one and only talk show dedicated to bringing you that is the best in the Bronx, New York, and the world, straight to your home. I'm Rina Valentin, your host and Café con Leche every Friday morning. And today's show is bound to be exciting, as you know, and here's just a taste of what's coming up. First up, we'll share some hidden gems of New York City in our Open Weekend Preview. Then we highlighted it last week, but we'll talk to some of the experts from all departments of next week's Mommy to Be Expo. And Bobby C's Sports Roundup will update us with all the happenings in the world of sports. And finally, in our Open Artist Spotlight, we'll flash back to some grooving rhythms of the Young Roots Performance Series. So don't go anywhere. All that is coming your way because now we are officially open. Welcome to Open. Rina Valentin here. And as always, we'd like to remind you to interact with us here on Open. It is only interactive if you are connecting with us. So reach out to us, send us an email to open@bronxnet.org and tweet us at BronxNetTV. And you can tweet me personally at Rina Valentin. And always, as always, remember to like us on Facebook. All right, we're going to get right into the show and see what this weekend has in store for us. You know it well, the Open Weekend Preview. First up, the night sky at Pelham Bay Park. This program aims at highlighting history and folklore of the solar system using the naked eye to locate stars and planets. Now, be sure to call ahead if the night sky isn't clear, okay? But that is happening this Saturday, March 2nd, from 6:45 p.m. to 8:30 p.m. at the Pelham Bay Ranger Station between Brooklyn Boulevard and Wilkinson Avenue. And for more information, you can call 718-352-1769. Then there's the Living in Sequence, Women in Comics panel at Poe Park. Join Regine Sawyer as she interviews women involved in the fields of comics and entertainment. That's happening Friday, March 8th and Saturday, March 9th, where she interviews different guests, including Aletha A.E. Martinez, Vanessa Verduga, Shauna Mills, Jamila Rouser, Tara Nakashima, Donahue, and Arana Emerson. This event is part of a series celebrating Poe Park's place in comics history. Poe Park is located at 2640 Grand Concourse in the Bronx. And for more information, call 718-365-5516. Again, that is happening March 8th and March 9th at 1 to 4 p.m. And, even more women power here. Forever Freestyle at Lehman Center. Back for the seventh year in a row and celebrating all the greats in freestyle. Brenda K. Starr, The Cover Girls, Suave, Judy Torres, Voice, Maribel, Lices Ferrer, TKA/47. This event is actually sure to bring the house down. You can tell I'm a freestyle girl. And the Lehman Center for the Performing Arts is located at 250 Bedford Park Boulevard, and that is in West Bronx. And that is happening this Saturday, March 2nd at 8 p.m. For more information, check out lehmancenter.org or you can call 718-960-8833. And that is what we have for you today. I hope you get out and enjoy. And as I say, you know I'm a freestyle girl, forever freestyle. I will always be forever freestyle. Vince, what do you think? That's not your era, Vince. That's not your era, even though you know I live in denial about the age factor. I'm just curious to know how that tune, that rhythm, right? Because, you know, everything kind of originates from hip-hop. However, freestyle had this generation of that just, it is its own mark. It's almost like classics. And so I just wonder how you feel about freestyle in this day and age. Because that's not your era. It's not your era.
Definitely not. Happy Friday.
Happy Friday, man.
No, it is not my era. I was introduced to freestyle a couple years ago. I went to a concert in Cortona Park. I think Judy Torres was there, actually.
Okay.
And it was really cool. Uh-huh. I liked it a lot.
What is your perception of it, right? Mm-hmm. Not having been raised in it and watching all these, you know, a little bit older people going crazy.
Yeah, it was interesting.
I'm one of them.
It was very interesting because I was like, what am I missing? What is this? I mean, it sounds cool. I think it has like roots in like electronic dance music. It's kind of like a Latin pop style. It's nice though. I thought it was weird at first, I must admit. But
what was so weird about it? I'm just curious.
Like you said, it was just like people like my mother's age and older, like, oh yeah, this is my
Oh no, you didn't just put me in your mother's age bracket.
No.
Did he just put me in your
I was like, I don't know what
are you implying I'm old?
No, Rena, no, never.
Oh, just check it.
But
all right, back at the ranch over here.
I do like it, though. I do like it. It has a nice feel to it. And a lot of music, I feel today, even sounds like some of the music back then. So.
All right. No, just because you brought in your mom.
Oh, goodness.
How is she rolling, right? She was doing that, you know, set it off. I suggest.
That's my song.
I'm telling you.
It's hotness.
All right. I gave myself up just because I'm a freestyle forever girl. I will always be a freestyle forever girl.
Freestyle forever.
Yes. Yes, forever and ever yours. All that. I'm not the singer, I'm the dancer. But yeah, so that's happening this weekend at Lehman Center.
This Saturday. I heard a lot of my friends talking about it, so yeah. I guess you know, it's something to see.
It's definitely something to see. Viz Bracey in the house playing his freestyle music. Well, not freestyle, but you know, he's freestyling. That's what's up. All right, so also we want to remind you of our makeup artist contest that's been happening, and this is actually the last week we are actually going to be accepting submissions to become our open makeup artist. And if you are interested, you can send an email to submissions@lareinadelbarrio.org with the subject line makeup artist contest to enter. And what you're looking at right now is our last makeup artist are doing my makeup on another show. And once again, send us emails to submission@lareinadelbarrio.org. All right, and after the break, we've got much more on Open, but first, a taste of next week's Rena Gets Lean.
Nineteen.
15 seconds.
20.
Way to work.
1.
2.
3.
2. Push yourself. Give me another one. I want one more. Extra. Very good. Nice.
Thank you.
Back up.
Thank you. Today's healthy habit to form. Eat at least 5 fruits and vegetables every day. My favorite fruits and vegetables, bananas and grape tomatoes.
Cook foods to the right temperature using a food thermometer. 3,000 Americans will die from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
We'll be right back.
Along with weight loss, it's one of the many ways to fight osteoarthritis pain. For more information on managing pain, go to fightarthritispain.org.
How you doing? I just want a regular, no sugar today.
You got it.
Thanks. Hello.
Hi.
Did you eat that whole thing today?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hi. How are you doing?
She's getting big, huh? Good.
Yeah, she is big. Let's go. Hey, haircut.
Yeah.
Yeah. Looks cute. Well, let's go. Nice to see you. Thanks a lot.
If only child abuse were this easy to recognize. If you even suspect abuse, call 1-800-4-A-CHILD. All calls are anonymous and confidential. Trust your instincts.
Hello, welcome back to Open, and today's show is going to be dedicated to the mommies during Women's History Month, which began today. That's right, March 2013. Open Friday is dedicated to the mothers. And Silvana DeFrancis is actually an acclaimed photographer and a natural storyteller. Her work highlights portrait design, editorial beauty, and bridal beauty. And next week, she will be photographing the Mommy to Be Expo. Please welcome Silvana DeFrancis.
Thank you. I'm happy to be here.
Hey, welcome, welcome, welcome. And, you know, it is it's an absolute pleasure to honor women, right?
Absolutely.
During Women's History Month. But it's even more refreshing to honor mothers. Right?
Yeah, for
sure. Being a new mom yourself.
Right.
Right? You're a mom to, how old is your baby?
She's two. Yeah, she's two and growing quickly. And I really just love working with mothers and helping them through their whole transition and coming, you know, to this beautiful stage in their life.
Now, from the photography storytelling perspective, it does take a certain type of feeling or consideration, or just there's an exchange that happens between the photographer and the subject, right?
Of course.
So as we're looking at in our beautiful display, you capture babies and mothers with a glow. So how is it that you begin this process? Like, how do you even start the process?
Well, I think you really need to connect on a personal level with the subject. It is a very intimate experience. You know, other than your hairstylist, nobody knows you better than your photographer, really. And, you know, I just make them feel comfortable. And the children, we take our time, especially with the babies, allow time for them to just get into a comfortable atmosphere. And we basically work with their time frame.
You know, Do you work with subjects from beginning to when they're born? Is that, how do you qualify packages? Like, do you do packages where it's a pregnant woman to the baby being born? Or do you do just the pregnancy and then just, or do you do packages? How does that work?
Yeah, packages. I find that I really follow or I grow with my subjects throughout their life. So it really starts with the maternity shoot with the expectant mom and then the newborn photos. And then we do baby's first year. So we do 3, 6, and 9 months. And then, of course, the first year portraits are fabulous. And we do fun cake smashes when the baby gets to have cake for the first time. And then I really find that I'm following them through life, through their, you know, other milestones. And it's really quite beautiful.
Now, you're a photographer and you in general. Mm-hmm. And but this seems to be something you're passionate about. Like, how did this find you, or how did you find it?
I think it was always knocking on my door. I have been a photographer forever. I worked in corporate for a very long time. And when I left, this was the only thing that was resonating with me. And it was just finally the time to listen. And I really decided to just put myself out there. And it's been wonderful so far.
Now, you know, every photographer usually has their own spin.
Right.
And in reviewing your work, I noticed that you have... Oops, sorry about that. I noticed that you have this... touch or hint of red that you tend to work with. Can you like share a little bit about like that? It's like an accent. Like I always find that the photographers always have like this accent that identifies their style. And I'm looking at one of your photos right here.
Yeah,
if you can
so
pull it out, that has the red and she has the red. And so I'm just curious what that is for you.
Well, Obviously, it proves that red is a very attractive and attracting color. It's warm. It represents the heart. It's very alive. It's vibrant. Its energy is very positive. So I find that it just adds that extra little pop to a photo. It's just, it works.
You use it a lot, though, because I saw it in a lot of, but you use it in different forms where you're able to make that red pop. And is that your signature? I'm just curious. It's something I observed.
Well, that's very intuitive of you. I do like to use it. Yes, yes. It's just my thing right now. I feel that it really connects with all of my subjects, whether they be women or babies or, you know, younger girls. So it's working for me. I love it.
And based on what I saw, you actually have the ability to create a catalog like that woman. I don't know who that photographer is that actually is very well known for making the babies become like objects.
Oh, Anne Geeds?
Yes.
Yes.
And you have your own take on that type of, because I saw there were babies in a basket. I mean, you should really visit her website. It's really fun to go through.
Thank you.
I had them all going through it.
Thank you.
So how do you come up with that? Like, for example, you have this child here with the crown on the head. You
know. Well, he was the firstborn son of, he was the first grandchild of a very large family. He's the prince, and he deserves to be represented that way. So so that was actually very fitting.
Okay, so before we go, just yes. Really quickly, the Mommy to Be Expo, which is where you're going to be, and you're raffling off a photo shoot, right?
I am, yes. So that is available for the lucky winner, and also in the welcome bags, there will be a $50 gift card for everybody who attends. So you can certainly apply that to your photo session.
All right, and the Mommy to Be Expo is on Sunday, March 10th,
absolutely,
at the Villa Barone, and it's going to be an all-day event, and we're all going to be there, and we hope that you're going to be there. Are there any last words you'd like to share with everyone before we go? It's apparent that you're a storyteller, and that's the beauty of your photography, so thank you.
Thank you very much for welcoming me, and I really look forward to being at the show.
Great, awesome. All right, once again, thank you once again to Savannah, and for more information and to see her work, you can go to SavannahDeFrancisPhotography.com. We do have to take a quick break, but when we return, we'll learn about a therapeutic approach to motherhood. Don't go anywhere.
For you. Hey, Mom.
You know, girls, I used to cheer back in my day. Ready? Okay!
That was amazing, amazing, amazing.
Mom, that was amazing.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of siblings in foster care who'll take you just as you are.
Two outs with a runner on first base. Now the big guy comes up with that, hitting 342 with 92 RBIs and 36 home runs.
Chill raw and prepared foods promptly. 1 in 6 Americans will get sick from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
You know, when I was younger, man, my brother was the one who really took care of me, man.
Is that right?
Hey, he'd wake me up in the morning, get me ready for school, take a shower, make me some breakfast.
Where your brother at now?
Oh, you know, all right. I get lonely, nobody to talk to. I felt like quitting school. He looked at my dad in my eye. He told me, if not for me, do it for him.
Give Josh and our class of 08 the boost they need to graduate. Join us at boostup.org.
I remember how much you said you liked mine.
Oh.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of siblings in foster care who take you just as you are.
Hello, welcome back to Open. We are honoring women in the beginning of Women's History Month. And most importantly, we are honoring mommies. And the Mommy to Be Expo aims to help new moms and moms to be the best moms that they can be. And they actually plan on showcasing some great products. And we've got some of them right here. So right now, we're going to welcome Dr. Elizabeth Chapner Thompson.
Good morning.
Good morning to you.
Thank you for having me.
And thank you for being here. So, of course, let's begin with, are you a mom?
I have four children.
Woo! Yeah. She's an experienced mom.
I'm an experienced mom. Our children are ages 9 to almost 15. So we've been through this, and we had them all at once. So it was pretty busy.
So, mom, and then you're a doctor in what field?
I'm a radiation oncologist. I actually did my internship as an OBGYN, though, in California. So I had lots of practice delivering babies as well.
Nice. So yeah. You are well-versed in the baby department.
I am.
Well, or the expectant department.
The expectant mother, say, yes. And getting through it, sure.
Yes. And you're also the creator of this wonderful product that is available to moms.
Yes.
Which, you know, when I started reading about it, I was like, where were you when I was getting ready to run to the hospital?
Yeah, I'm a good list maker, and I also like to be organized and prepared, and so we put this together for moms to help them.
This is the awesomest gift I've ever seen for moms to be.
It is, because we always focus on the baby, and here's the mom. We're going to focus on her.
And to be very honest with you, no matter how prepared you are, somehow when you get to the hospital, you don't have everything you need, right? Somehow when you are like, because we're trained to actually basically be prepared, right? And then when you get there, you're like, oh, I forgot this, I forgot that.
Sure.
Whereas you actually provide it all in one bag. So it's not just buying the bag, it's buying the bag and the products in the bag.
So, the bag itself is wonderful because it's stain resistant, it doesn't sit on the hospital floor, but it's the contents that really, that's the meat of it. And we really intend to do so much for the mom besides just putting in the flip-flops so she doesn't have to stand on the shower floor. We want her to relax, and so we have a little relax package here where we put in things to soothe the mom and make her calm, give her something to do while she's in labor and thinking about when is the baby coming. We have a little snack there for her or for her partner. And then we also focus on the recovery, of course.
And this is called the Biffle Bag?
It's called the Biffle Bag. All of our bags, it stands for Best Friends for Life because it's really meant to be a gift from one friend to another.
Right. So in other words, hint, hint, this is the gift that you purchase for baby showers. This is the gift of all gifts.
It's great. Yeah, we have had so many moms send it to daughters, sisters send it to sisters, husbands send it to wives. You name it. We've seen every combination.
You know, it's really interesting, right? She's a doctor. One of the first things she said was, it's stain resistant. You know, so she paid attention to all the details.
Sure, and it also doesn't weigh very much. So for a mom coming in, so when you're pregnant, you're not supposed to carry too much towards the end of pregnancy. And then when you're in the hospital, if you've had a cesarean section or even just a traditional birth, you're not supposed to carry too much more than your baby. So it's lightweight as well.
Okay, so you did kind of go through some of the items that we have that are visible, but we really didn't talk about the pillow.
The pillow is really the heart, no pun intended, of all of our Biffle bags. The Axilla pillow is meant to be a bracing pillow. So, yep, go ahead.
Oh,
it's wonderful.
I didn't feel it. I saw it, but I didn't feel it.
You know, nowadays in the hospital, if they give you a bracing pillow, it's a hard batting pillow that they must have developed in 1920.
Right.
This is a microfiber, micro bead pillow, and you can use it to sit up. You can also use it as a nursing pillow. And it's not one of those big things that you have to put around your waist. This is something that's small enough that you can actually tote around with you afterwards for comfort.
Right. This is awesome. Like, this is the versatile pillow so that you can resort to grabbing the pillow instead
of the man. Oh, the other thing
right?
is...
Right? Like, when that time comes? No, because men are like...
No, but it's so hard to get comfortable, too. Did you have back pain? Because I had so much back pain. And I found that a small pillow like that was great when I was in labor and to take a nap, too.
And the beauty of it, it's in the bag. It's in the bag.
You don't have to look for it. Right. It's in there.
It's in the bag. Oh, I'm loving this bag. I'm loving this bag. And so you did say we had some therapeutic stuff here.
Sure. So we thought of everything that the mom needs after she delivers. So we have from disposable underwear to also if you've had a cesarean, sometimes you just don't have gauze and tape at home to cover your incision. We put that in here. There are night pads. In addition, we have ice packs, and that goes down there or up here for if you're sore. Right. In addition, we have organic bamboo or reusable cotton nursing pads so that you can actually have them for your bra right away, no leaking or anything like that. And then we also put in this great water bottle, which one of your staff saw before. You can fold this up and carry it around with you because nursing mothers always need to be drinking. And it can also be filled with warm water and used as a peri bottle. Nice. So it has many uses. And then we also give toiletries. So when you're in the hospital and you go through labor and then you have a wonderful photographer coming in to take your picture.
Right, like Silvana, right?
Silvana, we give you some things to clean yourself up. So it's all the toiletries you might have forgotten, from a disposable toothbrush to eye drops, earplugs, you name it, it's in there.
Right, I got that. She said, you name it, it's in there. She's a doctor. This is well thought out.
Also, you know, when you take your shower, then we have moisturizer for your body so that you actually feel good and fresh afterwards too. And then lastly, we get you organized for going home and nursing your baby or feeding your baby, keeping records and your doctor's appointments.
And also, just to mention, because I did go through your website as well, the bag comes in various colors.
So we have bags for you name whatever condition, or if not just for a mom having a baby, but for if you have a best friend who unfortunately has cancer or is having a hysterectomy, if you have a friend who's going in for any type of surgery or procedure, we can make a bag for them. If you don't see it on the website, just send us an email. It's biffleco.com is our website, and info@biffleco.com will make a custom bag for you.
And you're also going to be raffling something off at the
Yes.
Mom-to-be
Oh,
Expo.
Yeah. We're going to be there. We're so excited to spread the word and to share with moms in the Bronx and all over New York. And we're just so thrilled to be here. Thank you so much for including me.
And thank you for being here. And thank you for coming up with this absolutely fabulous gift idea. It's a fabulous gift idea.
Thank you.
But I won't be having another one.
Well, you never know, right?
I know. I'm just putting it out there just in case. So once again, thank you. And thank you for this lovely gift idea once again. And for more information, you can go to biffleco.com, which is BFFLCO.com for the Biffle bag. And we do have to take a quick break. But when we return, we'll share more motherhood tips. Don't go anywhere.
This is so cool, Dad.
Awesome.
This is so cool, Dad.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of siblings in foster care who'll take you just as you are.
Hi, I'm Sonya Richards of the 2008 U.S. Track and Field Team. I'm here with our friends from Jane and the Dragon to say...
The amount counts, so keep portions under control.
When you're on the go, there's nothing better than a healthy snack to give you a boost. But remember, portions count too.
I love fast food. Fruit, that is. It's the perfect size and great to eat on the fly.
You've got the idea. For fun ways to get healthy, visit www.smallstep.gov.
Big dreams and good grades aren't enough to get into college. There are actual steps you need to take. Finding someone who can help is the first and most important. For the next steps, go to knowhowtogo.org.
Oh, I must be careful. Well, that's a nice picture.
Come on, Anna.
Okay.
Foreclosure doesn't affect just you. It affects your whole family, too. If you've fallen behind on your mortgage, we can help. Call 1-888-995-HOPE, because nothing is worse than doing nothing.
Hello, welcome back to Open as we continue to highlight motherhood. As a new mother, the world can be daunting and stressful. So there's so much to learn about the new life you're responsible for. And today in the studio, we've had already two demonstrations, and now we have the spa director for the mommy to be, well, the treatments that is going to appear in the Mommy to Be Expo. Please welcome Carline Vargas Gonzalez.
Thank you.
Did I say your name right?
Carline. It's okay.
Carline. Okay, so the MJ treatment is, it looks like you've got beads going on there. So tell us a little bit about the treatments that are offered for prenatal, right? It's for prenatal.
Right. We have a variety of different treatments available. We have therapeutic massage. We don't only focus on the actual expecting mother, but also if they're trying, we have services that can allow them to help conceive, as well as postpartum services. We also offered a variety of different facial packages where, you know, a lot of skin problems can occur when you're pregnant. So we can definitely address that as well. And then we also offer doula services, which is labor support.
Wow, that's really interesting. So doula is actually the new term for midwife, right?
Well, yes and no.
Yes and no.
Okay. We don't deliver the baby. Right. We're more there for the expected mother and their partner.
Okay.
So kind of more of a liaison with the doctor and the patient.
Okay, so when people go to the MJ treatment, there are various staff members that are like qualified in all these different areas, is what you're saying.
Yes, yes. We have a massage therapist on staff. Besides the spa director, I'm also the lead esthetician and the doula. So we have a nice variety of different mixed services in our location.
Oh, good. So since you're the doula, share a little bit about your doula experiences. I don't know, would it be like a doula-ing or no? I'm just No, but just share a little bit. Like, what's the process? Like, when should a person obtain a doula? How's that?
It can be even the day that you're going into contraction to labor. You can actually say, you know what? I think I want somebody there to support me besides my partner. Or as early as finding out that same day that you're actually conceiving and you're expecting. So there's really no set time of saying, oh, you know, 6 weeks before or 8 weeks before or a week before. It's more of when you're ready. I definitely say and suggest for them to do the research and look for a person that they feel a common bond and communication with them.
Okay, so why would someone seek a doula? Just so that they're clear of the doula responsibilities. Because, you know, I went to Lamaze class, you know, and that was for nothing because I ended up getting a C-section. I'm still having issues getting past that. However, I would have loved to have had a doula, and I found out about it afterwards.
There are doulas even for C-sections. It's more of an emotional support for that patient because you may have your partner there. They may not completely understand, or if once the baby is born, that partner is going to be concerned about the baby. So you want a doula that's more for the mommy, more of how you're feeling. Do you want ice chips? Kind of like your mom. You want somebody to kind of help you out and help you with the process. Give you different ideas of turning, also to communicate with the doctor as what options you have available. Not many patients understand what their rights are as a patient. So when you have a doula there, they can kind of more or less tell you like, well, what are other options? Can you explain to her, you know, X, Y, and Z to her so that she knows she does have a voice in the labor room.
Now, when it comes to the treatments, now, how does that relate to being a doula?
The treatments, as you probably experience, you know, you have the swelling and you're just uncomfortable. There are different ways that you can get a therapeutic massage where it can kind of release all of that stress for you.
Okay, so MJ treatment is not just a spa, obviously. It's like a one-stop shop for women pampering. Yay, yes. We love that. And so just because you named all of these fabulous services that you offer, are you guys geared more towards women who are pregnant, maternity, or is it just women in general and you snatch them at prenatal and then and then you take them through postpartum? Because postpartum is underrated as well. People tend to think it's like psychological and it's something physical.
It is. It's emotional as well. But we have our niche and our idea started with moms and kind of geared towards women and kind of brought out to that with their partners and their family. So it's kind of a little bit of everything.
Okay. So what would you like women to leave here with regards to MJ treatment, which happens to be located in the Bronx, people?
I say do your research. Look at the location. There are many different ways to pick for a location. Obviously, I'm from the MJ treatment and I'm obviously going to promote that. But look at the location, are there staff certified and qualified for it, the type of equipment that they have, because some people, you know, you've seen the table with the hole in it, that's, you know, not the correct way to have a therapeutic massage. So you want to make sure you do your research, get your partner involved.
Right, because when it comes to massaging as a masseuse, there are people who are certified as prenatal masseuse, and that's different too. So you have to be very careful. Like, so regular massages are not exactly the same, because there are certain points in the body that really shouldn't be touched when you're pregnant.
Correct.
So, and you specialize in that. Well, not you, but the spa itself specializes in that. And they're also going to be part of the Mommy to Be Expo, which I'm proud to be a part of as well. I'm part of the Mommy to Be Expo. And you're also going to be raffling off a treatment at the spa. The Mommy to at the spa. My mind is at the spa, obviously. I want to sit on this table.
Right. And we'll also be doing 2-minute demonstrations at the expo. So if you want to come on by, get a free little mini massage. We'll also be taking appointments. We also do spa parties. So it's a big thing for, like, baby showers, where you can have your guests come in and do the treatment and kind of do something a little different rather than your standard big chair and gifts and everybody coming over.
Awesome, awesome. And thank you so much for
being here. Thank you for having me.
And where is MJ Treatment located?
We're located on Paulding Avenue between Allenton and Arnold's, kind of the Gun Hill, Pelham Parkway area.
Awesome. Thank you so much. All right. So once again, this is all happening on Sunday, March 10th, people. The Mommy Expo. Mommy to Be Expo is happening Sunday, March 10th from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. And that's happening at the Villa Barone. And I suggest that you guys get to it, because whether you're a mommy to be or whether you are a mommy, the things that are going to be discussed there and shared are only going to enhance your level of knowledge in, you know, whether it's pampering yourself as a woman or, you know, just making yourself, assisting yourself in valuing yourself so that you can be a better mom. That's really what it's all about, because you know what? It starts with the moms first. You're the first role model. We're the first role model. And again, I'm really excited about the Mommy to Be Expo. I hope you are too. And I hope we see you there. All right, so after the break, Bobby C is going to be coming up and he's going to be updating us on those sports. So stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Out a hand to one, we can influence the condition of all. That's what it means to live united.
Low-fat cheese sandwiches on whole wheat bread. Chewy and good for you. Snacks high in calcium help build strong bones, and foods rich in fiber are good for your heart, so you have the power to dominate. Can your food do that? Run, throw, think, eat better. Find out more at smallstep.gov.
We begin on the NBA hardwood and our latest New York Knicks insider. The New York Knicks are trying to find their post-All-Star break groove. Sunday night was a step in the right direction as the Orange and Blue snapped a four-game losing streak and a victory over Atlantic Division foe Philadelphia. In the process, the Knickerbockers won their first game of the second half.
I like the way we played, though. The bottom line is we had to win this tonight just to kind of get off this slide.
The Knicks are gearing up for the stretch run and have added a piece to their bench and veteran forward Kenyon Martin. Martin, who suited up Sunday but did not see the floor, was serenaded with chants from the home crowd.
Just let my play speak for itself when I rest up out there. There ain't no pressure. Basketball is basketball. So when I get out there, they like what I do, then hopefully I'll be back.
Carmelo Anthony and Amari Stoudemire are certainly finding their way. Anthony was the high man on Sunday, and Amari came off the bench for 22 points.
Our practice has been a lot more physical than even the game that we've been playing. So when we can beat up on each other like that and practice and compete against each other, you know, going in the game should be easy.
Just sticking with the defense gives me being aggressive, being patient.
Point guard Ray Felton, who has battled some injuries of late, likes the state of the Knicks right now.
We want to get back to playing the way we were playing early in the year. You know, really pushing the ball, being aggressive, you know, everybody being aggressive. So, yeah, that's a big emphasis for us.
You realize that this is kind of the last 20, 30 games of the season before you would, you know, dig in. I think that's the main thing is guys understand that, look, you know, this is important right now. We're going to maintain where we are and get better.
The Knicks made it two straight on Wednesday night, navigating around a league season-high 54 points from Golden State's Stephen Curry. The sharpshooter nailed 11 threes, but Carmelo Anthony and company held on 109-105. Anthony and J.R. Smith had clutch baskets down the stretch in the win. The Orange and Blue will be in Washington tonight before returning home for a huge matchup with Miami on Sunday at the Garden. LeBron James and the Heat have been in fuego of late. Tip-off on Sunday is at 1 p.m. Knicks reserve forward Rasheed Wallace, who has been sidelined by injury, will be out for up to 8 weeks. Some have suggested that the Knicks cut ties with Wallace and attempt to sign another defensive-minded player for their backcourt. Meanwhile, the Brooklyn Nets are home tonight for Dallas before traveling to Chicago for a Saturday matchup with the Bulls. The Nets are 2-2 over their last four, including a 101-97 road win against New Orleans on Tuesday night. We shift gears from the NBA to the baseball diamond. Spring training is in full swing. Out at Bronx Bombers camp, Derek Jeter and Mariano Rivera are on the mend. Rivera has begun throwing, and Jeter is taking part in drills. Alex Rodriguez continues to make headlines no matter what the story. This week it was his cousin selling his 2009 World Series ring. The media failed to mention that it's an exact replica that A-Rod had purchased for his cousin. Nonetheless, it was fetching some serious bids in auction. Curtis Granderson will be sidelined for 10 weeks. Not good news. Hit by a pitch in spring training game number 2. The Bombers are mulling former pinstripers like Johnny Damon and Alfonso Soriano. I would take either or, but preferably Soriano. Time for some quick hitters from around the world of sports. From Mets camp, phenom prospect Zach Wheeler has some oblique issues. That's something to watch. The flame-throwing right-hander is expected to be in the mix sometime this season for the rebuilding Mets. Meanwhile, from rookie news to old-timer news, veteran Met outfielder Marlon Byrd said he will retire if he doesn't make the club. The Amazons are thin in the outfield, so expect Byrd, if he can manage anything this spring offensively, to make the club. The latest move to legalize mixed martial arts in New York took another step forward on Thursday. The state's Senate Committee on Cultural Affairs, Tourism, Parks, and Recreation voted 11-3 on a bill to support the sport. In an unrelated story, an NBA scout said this week that the Knicks' second unit does not scare anyone. Well, thank you, genius. The Knicks bench has seen its share of injury of late, and it appears, at least to a certain extent, that age may be finally catching up with some of the veterans on the squad. Coach Mike Woodson will need to continue mixing and matching with the finish line of the regular season quickly approaching. The same could be said on the NHL ice. The shortened season seems to be skating by. The Broadway Blue Shirts have not had an easy go of it of late. However, the New York Rangers did put together a nice win on Thursday night, topping the Tampa Bay Lightning at the Garden 4-1, and Rick Nash's return from injury. Nash even had a goal in the win. The Rangers are 9-8-2 on the season and will be at home on Sunday night to host Buffalo. On the NFL gridiron, former San Francisco starting quarterback Alex Smith has been dealt to Kansas City. The Niners appear to be also possible players in a deal with the New York Jets for Darrell Revis, although all accounts of late seem that a possible deal has cooled. The Jets are working out veteran quarterback David Gerrard. If he has anything left, he could be signed and could possibly compete with Mark Sanchez for the starting QB job. The NFL Combine also wrapped up, and Manti Te'o, of course, made plenty of headlines from some reports at least. NFL teams did inquire about his sexuality.
That's an easy one. He dates invisible women. Those are the headlines. We hit the C-list for some thoughts on the Bronx Bombers and their primetime all-star second baseman, Robinson Cano. For the first time in a long time, the Pinstripers are not the favorites to win the American League East. The Yankees folks are underdogs, shockingly. I'm sure a lot of this has to do with the fact that age, at least in the eyes of many, could be a contributing factor for the Bronx Bombers' demise. One Yankee that is in his prime, though, is all-star second baseman Robinson Cano, who you just saw right there. General Manager Brian Cashman said this week that the soon-to-be free agent made a significant offer from the club. This was done in an attempt to avoid getting into a bidding war for his services this winter. A 308 lifetime hitter who batted 313 with 33 home runs and 94 RBIs last season could pull a contract in the neighborhood of $225 million. Maybe even Albert Pujols-like $240 mil for 10 years. As much as I love Robbie Cano, I'm not sure if the Bombers can make that kind of commitment. That's a lot of money moving forward. I'd do 5, maybe 6 years, but I'll tell you, if Cano is adamant about getting that 10-year backbreaker of a deal, the Yanks should be considering moving Robinson Cano. I have two words for you folks, Alex Rodriguez. Take a look at that contract and get back to me. That's your sports. I'm Bobby C. Hit me up on Twitter. Let me know what you're thinking. Robbie Cano or not? We'll have more open after this.
How you doing?
Hi.
Have a nice day.
You too.
Thanks.
If only child abuse were this easy to recognize. If you even suspect abuse, call 1-800-4-A-CHILD. All calls are anonymous and confidential. Trust your instincts.
Megan? You're a tramp. Ryan Fitch told me you guys made out. Everybody knows. He says you're your most desperate girl he knows, besides your mom. How many boyfriends does she have anyway? Lots? That zit is huge. Zit face.
Oh, I must be careful. Well, that's a nice picture.
Come on, Anna.
Okay.
Foreclosure doesn't affect just you. It affects your whole family, too. If you've fallen behind on your mortgage, we can help. Call 1-888-995-HOPE because nothing is worse than doing nothing.
Lose their babies to gun crimes. You'll always be your mother's baby. So before you commit a gun crime, think about who you'll leave behind. Gun crimes hit home.
Hello, welcome back to Open, and we're gonna go back in time for this one. Here's a look at Bate y Macori on Open last year. Hello, welcome back to Open. Rina Valentin here. We are so ready. That's right. The lights are burning at this point, and they are, well, you know, they're shining. It looks like the stage is set too, because it is now time for our Open Artist Spotlight.
The Open Artist Spotlight is made possible in part with public funds from the Bronx Council on the Arts through the New York State Council on the Arts Decentralization Program.
The Young Roots is a performance series that showcases emerging artists experimenting with the artistic roots of Afro-Latino traditions to create new branches that reach into the future. The newest edition fuses dance, theater, and live music in the African Caribbean tradition. That's right, the African Caribbean tradition. Please welcome to the stage, Bate y Macori! hate those performances. Okay, you want to introduce everybody?
Yeah, this is Camilo Molina, and Fidel Paulino, two of the drummers.
And the dancers. This is Bate y Macori, and we're going to explain to everybody what this is. This is part of the Young Roots series, and the dancers.
This is Beatrice Capodi, and this is Shanann Jensen.
Beautiful, thank you. Beautiful, beautiful. So I came in doing a little dance with you. Sika's going to share with us a little bit. Oh, we need a microphone for you, sorry. That's for you.
Yep.
So can you just share with everybody a little bit about Bate y Macori and what those dance moves represent?
Sure. So we're doing a show, I've got my cheat sheet here, at Hostel Center for Arts and Culture called Bate y Macori Senderos de Carbón, Carbon Pathways. And this dance is an exploration of Gaga and Guloya, which are two Afro-Dominican dance and music traditions that take us to both Haiti and the British Islands. They came to Dominican Republic with the sugar trade industry, mm-hmm. and so those traditions have been practiced in the streets for decades now in Dominican Republic. They're part of our Afro-Dominican tradition, and we're really happy to be exploring these traditions and this music with you at Hostos this September,
very exciting.
Friday, September 30th, and Saturday, October 1st at 7:30 p.m.
All right, and that was Young Roots, and to check out their next installment with Rockefeller, that's happening on March 21st at Hostos. And for more information on Young Roots, go to hostos.cuny.edu. And I'm here with the ladies of the Mommy to Be Expo, and we are all inviting you, because I'm part of it as well, to make sure you mark your calendars for March 10th from 11 to 3 p.m. It is going to be an affair not to be missed. It's going to be one big baby shower. And if you're interested in more information, you can go to mommytobeny.com. Go to mommytobeny.com. Ladies, do you have any last words?
Thank you.
Absolutely.
Fun morning.
Wonderful.
And
we'll see you there next week.
Yes, we'll see you. Right, exactly. We'll see you all next Sunday at the Villa Barone Manor. Whether you're a mom or not, right? It's all about, you know, the mommies to bees, as well as the mommies, the grandmas, even the daddies. It's just one big baby shower. Everybody just come out. All right, that is all the time we have for today's show. And we'd like to thank all of you for coming.
Here's
the
pillow.
All right, I got the heart pillow, people. And that was a nice little flashback that we had as we prepare for the future, as we're doing today. And thank you, ladies, once again for joining us. And thank you, viewers, for tuning in. And if you missed any part of today's show, you can tune into the Recablecast tonight at 5 and 10 p.m. and throughout the entire weekend. And remember to follow us online and send us a message or two. And you can find us at bronxnet.org. Once again, I'm Rina Valentin. And from all of us here, may the universe provide peace, prosperity, and love. Mwah. Adios. Woo! Yes.
kitchen surfaces, utensils, and hands with soapy water. 1 in 6 Americans will get sick from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
My name's Brandon. 9 years old, being an alcoholic.
Hi, Brandon.
I'll start drinking with the older kids. And whatever they do, I'll do.
Kids who drink before age 15 are 5 times more likely to have alcohol problems when they're adults. So start talking before they start drinking.
I know I'll start with alcohol. I'm just not sure how it's gonna end.